Well, I'm here at this very unusual government freedom conference. That's like saying jumbo shrimp, right? Is it government or is it freedom? The two things, it's like oil and water. They don't really mix. It's a very unusual place. There's this mural that we're all invited to sort of paint by numbers, and I didn't want to deface it, so I painted one of these little dialogue bubbles, and inside I wrote a few words of dialogue. I wrote, "Free Tommy Robinson," my penmanship isn't great, and I could feel people tensing up a little bit. It hasn't been colored over yet. One fellow from the Sydney Morning Herald walked up and recognized me, and he said, "Oh, so you're one of those free speechers, are you?" Yeah, I thought we all were, mate, because we're here at a free speech conference. Well, the artists seemed to be pretty cool with me writing it. In fact, one of them suggested I not use a paintbrush, but rather a marker. I wish I had known that in advance, because my penmanship was awful. But I'm having fun already, and I'll check back a little bit later to see if someone has scribbled over my comment. You know what? I think each of these little speech bubbles should have a little comment in them. And the whole point is that they be a little bit dissident, and by that I mean something that you need freedom to say. On this half, you know, people are not allowed to say things if they're behind barbed wire. On this half, they're free to say things, and really, if it's just talking about like the weather and sports scores and recipes and slice of life stories, what's the point? I think the whole point of free speech is that you can say things that frankly irritate some people, like Free Tommy Robinson, Mike, and if you don't believe in that, I just don't think you believe in freedom. I think there's a lot of people at this Government Freedom Conference that probably don't. Anyways, to see the rest of my videos, go to mediafreedomconference.com. I'm here in the United Kingdom for the Media Freedom Conference that appears to be anything but. It's an Orwellian gathering of the Canadian and British governments who are both engaging in massive censorship on social media, but they're going to swan about a bit with celebrities like Amal Clooney pretending they believe in civil liberties. We'll see over the course of the next 2 days if they will. If you want to see all our videos and chip in to cover our journalistic costs, we're independent, unlike most media here, please go to mediafreedomconference.com.